Hey guys, this is Austin. If you're into computers, you've probably heard about AMD's Ryzen, but what's all the hype about? So AMD invited us out to San Francisco, where we got to learn a ton about the brand new Ryzen 7 processors. Now these are high-end. We're talking about prices between $330 and $500. However, they have very high-end performance to match. All Ryzen 7 processors have 8 cores with hyper-threading, you can overclock them, and they don't even have integrated graphics. They really are completely targeted toward the high-end desktop market, whether you're gaming, editing, whatever. So what I'm curious about is what they're actually like to use. So the first thing I want to check out is the demo showcase. So AMD has a lot of different Ryzen systems here, including a couple, maybe Core i7s. So one of the big advantages that Ryzen has are more cores that are just about as fast as what you'll find on the Intel side. So for example, at about the same price, on this side they have an R7 1700, and on this side there's an i7 7700K. Now the big difference here is that while this is a 4-core hyper-threaded system, this is an 8-core hyper-threaded system. So in theory, we should be able to see a pretty big difference. So Ryzen looks like it's going to be a bit faster. So right now we're averaging about 63 frames per second here, whereas on the i7 it's about 58. So this is a good example. So the Ryzen chip, even though it does have 8 cores, it's running at about like 3.1, 3.2 gigahertz, whereas the i7 is running at about 4.3 right now. But more cores are definitely going to help with a task like this. Like here we go, so it's finishing up, and it took almost exactly 1 minute. Whereas over here, minute and 10 seconds. So not a huge difference, but I think this is a good example of why more cores can definitely be helpful when it comes to video editing, streaming, that kind of stuff.
This chip on the right costs less than this chip on the left.
Really?
Yeah. Wait, oh. You were in the same presentation I was.
Don't worry, I'll be on the side. What have you guys seen yet? Well, what? It's like a pretty standard looking cooler. It's definitely a big card though. So this is pretty much the full like 2017 AMD setup. So not only does it have the new Ryzen CPU, but it also has a
really cool graphics card.
So we can actually play on it right now. Based on the size of it, I assume this is probably one of their new
totally normal GPUs.
But honestly, I have no idea. But it runs Battlefront. I feel like I need to leave here before someone yells at me. I don't think I'm supposed to be looking at this. So what's interesting here is that while these are both 8-core CPUs, the Ryzen chips are going to be significantly less expensive. So this guy runs, I think, about like $1,000 or so, whereas even the high-end Ryzen, the 1800X, that's still only going to be $500. And if you don't need that extra clock speed, you can get an 8-core chip for $330. The amount of cores you need does depend on what you're doing. So for gaming, I still do think that 4 cores is still probably going to be enough. 8 cores is not going to magically make your game run twice as fast. However, if you are doing things like editing, streaming, that kind of stuff, then the extra power can come in handy. Especially when you consider that it's about the same price and you're just getting more, kind of seems like a no-brainer. But of course, we will find out when I actually get my hands on, not Cinebench at the AMD demo room. Ryzen 7 will be available for pre-order starting today, and it will be on sale March 1st. So you get 3 different options. There's Ryzen 7 1700, which will cost you $330. There's 1700X, which will cost you $400. And there's 1800X, which will cost you $500. Now, even though there's a big price difference, they're all 8 core and they're all essentially the same. The biggest difference is the clock speed and how high you can overclock. On top of Ryzen 7, which is exciting on the high end, if the leaks and rumors are to be believed, then there might be some lower end options coming soon. So definitely be sure to let me know what you guys think about Ryzen in the comments below, and stay tuned, there may be a couple PC builds coming soon.